guys, welcome back to Design Plus School. This is Surasit. I'm back for another tutorial. Today I will show you the basic of prototyping and Figma. So are you ready? Let's do it. We're going to prototype a movie ticket booking app. We will learn how to include horizontal and vertical scrolling, which is very common in all apps. We will learn how to include slide in from the left when you click on the content. Click on read mode to read the complete storyline. Select the date and the button will be colorful. We will include animation for the reservation button. Now choose the seat. I don't want to be alone, so I'm gonna select another seat. And then the bill just appear and click on the buy. We will include animation for the reservation button, the bill and the ticket by using onDrag and Smart Anim. At the beginning and my intro, I test my design with Figma Mirror. Go to App Store, download the application called Figma and FigJam, and then test your design. First, we need to have our design built. I take my last UI design, the movie ticket booking. So I create the home page that did not appear in my previous tutorial. I'm not going to show you how to create it. Today, I will focus only on the prototype and not on the design. Don't worry guys, I will share my Figma file with you. I place all the screen in order. It will be easier to follow the step by following the order of the numbers. The number one is the home page. It's going to be the starter position of our prototype. First, I'm gonna hide the other frame. Now we're going to focus on the first connection. Click on the prototype mode and click on the flow starting point. You will see a blue rectangle with an arrow appearing on the top left side. You can change the starting position anytime by dragging on another frame. I will show you how to add horizontal and vertical scrolling to your Figma prototype for the homepage. Go back to design. So I want each movie category to scroll horizontally. And I want my title to stay in place. I unclip the content to see all the contents that roll off the page. As you can see, I put the movies in an auto layout. Now, we must put them in a frame. I want each category to scroll horizontal and all the movies to scroll vertically. Select the movies in the category, right-click, and click on frame selection. We're going to reduce the width, so we're going to drag it the frame until it hit the side of the screen. Repeat the same thing to the other movie category. Go back to prototype and click on horizontal scrolling. Repeat the same thing. Go back to design. I'm going to clip content to make the other content invisible. Now I'm going to select everything and I'm going to put them in another frame. So click on frame selection. Gonna do the same thing. We're gonna drag it till it's hit the side of the screen. And now I'm going to click content. So I'm gonna select my frame and click content like this. Let me name my layer by vertical scrolling. So So I put the start bar, the title, and the search field in another frame because I don't want them to move. They will stay in place. Select the frame, go to prototype, and click on vertical scrolling. Now go to play. Okay, it's working. Wow. So did you see when we scroll it vertically, it stopped below the search field. Great. Let's create a first connection. I want to be able to click on the movie that I want to see in the cinema. Then the reservation page will slide in on the left. Select the image movie. We have to put in a frame. Click on frame selection. So you will see a blue circular node appear on the right side of the element. To make a connection, click on this node and drag in frame number 2. You will see interaction detail windows. So click on unclick. And now for the animation, I'm going to choose sliding because I want the reservation to slide in. And click on easy in and out. Add another connection. I want to be able to go back to the home menu. Select the arrow left, put in a frame. It's already in a frame. And drag in frame number 1. Again, click on click. I'm gonna choose smart animation. Is it in, is it out? And you can change the time if you want it to be more faster or more slower. But I'm gonna keep it like that. So let's try it. Click on play. So I'm gonna click on the movie. I wanna go back. Okay, perfect. Okay, bring frame number 3. So as you can see, I hide my reservation button on frame 2, 3, and 4. So smart animation looks for matching layer that exists across multiple frames. It recognizes what changed and apply transition to animate between them. So my reservation button will appear from the button. Select number 2. We're gonna select the read mode. So one, we click read mode, the complete storyline will appear. Click on the text, make sure it's in the frame, drag and frame number 3, unclick smart animation, easy in, easy out, and then click on frame number 3 and drag and frame number 2, unclick smart animation, easy in and out. Okay, let's try it. Perfect. Okay, now click on frame number 3. I want to select my date. I want my button to become colorful. So in the frame number 4, I change the button for a colorful gradient. So select the date. Make sure it's in the frame, drag, and number 4. It's gonna be on click. I don't know why I say smart animation, but it's smart animate. Easy in, easy out. Go to frame number 4. Now we're gonna click on the time. It's time to reserve what time you want to go to the cinema. It will transform in a colorful button. Drag in frame number 5, on click. Small anip, easy in and easy out. Okay, let's try it. Whoops. So I click, it's become another color. Wow, so did you see the reservation button is come from the button? You can change the second. Click on the time again. Let me try something. I'm gonna change the number to 600 just to see. Okay? Okay, let's try it. Okay, it's more slow. Okay, I'm gonna keep it like that. So it's a little bit more slower. Let's bring the number 6. And then the number 7 and the number 8. We're gonna choose the C. And when we click on the C, it's changed to another color. So when you finish to choose your C, they will have a bill will appear from the button, like the reservation button. Okay, select the reservation button. Make sure it's in a frame. Draw and frame number 6. It's going to be on click smart animation, easy in and out. Gonna change the number to 300. So now I'm gonna select my seat and draw and frame number 7. So it's gonna be the same thing on click smart animation, easy in and out. Click on frame 7, select the other C, draw and frame number 8. It's gonna be on click smart animation. I'm gonna change the second to 600. There's something that I don't like and I have to resolve it. So let's take the frame number 3. I'm gonna put it below the frame number 2. So I see my mistake. So go to frame 3, remove this connection. It will be this one. So click on frame number 2 and drag in frame number 4. So it's gonna be the same on click smart animation. Okay, let's try it again. Okay, now it's working. Good. So I'm gonna bring frame number 9. So select the buy button, make sure he's in the frame and drag in frame number 9. It's going to be on click smart animation. And I'm gonna change the number to 300. Let's try it. Voila. Okay, bring the frame number 10 and 11. Okay, how I designed my ticket, it's a little bit more complex. I'm going to show you very quickly how I do my design. Like I say, I want to focus only on the prototype, because if I show you at the beginning the design and the prototype, the video will be very long and I don't want you guys to fall asleep. You have to move your ticket frame and each frame. So the ticket number 1 is at the bottom. You can see that in the frame 9. The ticket number 2 is behind. Now it become in the front. But we have to replace the ticket 2 to this place. So you duplicate and you do the same thing. Ticket 3 is become in the front and we have to replace the ticket 2 and put it behind the ticket number 3. We have to move the layer so the ticket underneath will lift and be on the front of the page. By using smart animate, the layer that I move will animate together. So click on frame number 9, go to prototype, select the frame number 9, and click on the ticket frame and draw on frame number 10. We're gonna select on draw, smart animation. Select the frame number 10, select the ticket frame and drag on frame number 11. We're gonna select on drag. Smart animation, easy in, easy out. Click on frame number 11, select the frame and drag to frame number 9. Click on drag. Smart animation. Where is my tab bar from the 9? Okay, click the tab bar and click on adding button. It's my mistake. Okay, now let's try again. So you can see that it's dry very nicely. Okay, now last step, we're gonna select each arrow left, go to the home page, and we're gonna select the home icon, drag to the home page, and we're gonna select the ticket draw to the ticket frame number 9. Click on the ticket icon, draw on frame number 9. It's going to be on click, smart animation. You know what? I'm gonna put the home page right here. It's gonna be more easy for us to see it. And we have the calendar icon that we can go back to the reservation page. So select the calendar icon and go back to the frame number 2. So everything must be connected. Okay, let's click on play. Congratulations, guys, so you know the basic of prototyping. Next step, you will learn by my coworker about more complex prototype like the animation using after delay. So thank you so much for watching. I hope that you enjoy and like the video. So don't forget to like and subscribe. See you next time. Bye.